This episode is sponsored by Magellan TV, a documentary streaming service founded by filmmakers. Journey to the Microcosmos viewers will get a one-month free trial on Magellan TV by clicking on the link in the description. Let's start today by agreeing on one thing. This is weird. We're looking at a dark purplish screen with little bits of white floating up towards the top as if they are bubbles rising to the top of a glass of grape soda. But that's not the weird part. The weird part happens when those bubbles suddenly move in concert away from the frothy edge, dragged towards one corner of the screen and then towards the other. The effect is cosmic, like we're watching a million stars get flung towards each corner of the sky. And it won't make it any less weird to know that we're not looking at bubbles or stars, we are looking at bacteria. A field of them shaped by an invisible force that they are innately built to respond to. Every swing towards one direction and then another is visual proof of this unseen thing. So what is it? What is the force that's driving them to move this way? Technically, it would not be wrong to say that the answer is James, our master of microscopes. When James first saw these bacteria, all he knew was that they came from a sample taken from a Portuguese beach. And on each slide, the bacteria were swimming in a stark line. And usually, it's not that strange to find bacteria swimming in a line, especially when you realize that those lines fall along particular chemical gradients that correspond with the bacteria's own needs. But what was weird to James is that the bacteria seemed to be congregating entirely on one side of the slide. At first, he thought that there might be some kind of food source over there that was drawing the bacteria towards that edge, so when he disposed of the slide, he moved on, not expecting to see it happen again. But the next day, James took a drop of water from his sample and added it to the slide, and there it was, another line, just like he had seen the day before. But the line was sticking to one side of the slide, almost as if they were being pulled by some invisible string in that direction. And that gave James an idea. He took out his phone and opened up his compass app, and then he placed the phone on the microscope stage to see what direction the bacteria were swimming in, and he found that the bacteria were all swimming north. So if we've seen this line of bacteria that's all swimming north, what's with the other things that we've been watching, where the bacteria look like they are being dragged in other directions? Well, as soon as James realized that his bacteria were swimming north, he decided to go and grab some magnets to see if he could trick them into thinking some other direction is north instead. So he held the north end of the magnet close to the slide, and the bacteria began to migrate, drawn in the direction of the magnet. And then he rotated the magnet so that the south end pointed closer, driving the bacteria to swim away. What James had found, what we are seeing in action, are magnetotactic bacteria, or bacteria whose movements are controlled by Earth's magnetic field. Magnetotactic bacteria were first described in 1963 by an Italian scientist named Salvatore Bellini, who found them living in freshwater. And when he saw them move with the same singular northward focus that ours have been exhibiting, he considered the idea that they might have some kind of internal compass within them. But while Bellini wrote up his work, it was only circulated as manuscripts to some of the universities in Italy instead of being published in a journal for more scientists to find. That meant that the existence of these bacteria wasn't widely known when, a decade later, a graduate student named Richard P. Blakemore collected some more bacteria from a pond in Massachusetts and witnessed that northward microscopic migration for himself. Blakemore coined the term magnetotaxis to describe what they were doing, and as he dove deeper into the bacteria to understand how they moved this way, he realized that they did, in fact, have their own internal compass. Or rather, compasses. Within these bacteria are a set of organelles called magnetosomes. The core of the magnetosome is a magnetic crystal, either iron oxide or iron sulfide, that's made through a series of processes that involve the cell taking in iron from its surroundings and mineralizing it within them. The crystal is then wrapped in a membrane to create a single magnetosome. But as we said, magnetotactic bacteria don't just have one magnetosome, they have a set of them, usually around 10 to 20, arranged in a chain to create a dipole that can respond to the magnetic field that crosses the world around the bacteria. Magnetotactic bacteria are found all around the world, but their preference is to live in areas with low levels of oxygen, like deeper down towards the sediment and away from the surface. And this preference has potentially important consequences for the direction that magnetotactic bacteria travel in. All of the magnetotactic bacteria discoveries we have described so far, including the bacteria we've been watching, travel north. However, all those bacteria share something else in common besides their propensity towards the North Pole. They all live in the Northern Hemisphere. Meanwhile, scientists have found that magnetotactic bacteria from the Southern Hemisphere will actually travel towards the South Pole. And this is probably due to the incline of our planet's geomagnetic fields, which means that as a bacterium travels towards its specified pole in its preferred hemisphere, it also swims downwards in the water towards the sediment it prefers. If a magnetotactic bacterium from the Southern Hemisphere was forced to navigate the magnetic field of the Northern Hemisphere instead, it would find itself swimming upwards, reaching waters higher in oxygen and far less comfortable for the bacterium. At least that is the hypothesis for why this apparent polarity within the distribution of bacteria exists. But as always, there are exceptions, southern-seeking bacteria found in the Northern Hemisphere, and other strange behaviors that scientists are still deciphering. There are many other mysteries to magnetotactic bacteria, like what advantages magnetism even gives them, whether it's to find the right habitat in the water, or to hunt down particular nutrients, or a combination of different factors. And the bacteria probably don't know why they move this way either. It is simply baked into them, a crystal that draws them into invisible tracks. They are mysterious and enigmatic. You might even call them magnetic. Thanks for coming on this journey with us as we explore the unseen world that surrounds us. And thank you again to Magellan TV for sponsoring this episode of Journey to the Microcosmos. There are a lot of unseen worlds that surround us, and while we tend to focus on the ones we can fit under the microscope, the James Webb Space Telescope is out there studying the atmospheres of exoplanets and searching for the building blocks of life elsewhere in the universe. And you can learn even more about that by watching Planet Hunting with the James Webb Space Telescope on Magellan TV. Magellan TV is a documentary streaming service founded by filmmakers. It has some of the most in-depth science content available anywhere, covering space, technology, nature, and more. 15 to 20 hours of new content is added every week, with a growing collection of 4K high-definition content for no additional cost, so you will never run out of something to watch. And there are no ads. Magellan TV can be watched anytime, anywhere on your television, laptop, or mobile device because it's compatible with Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Apple TV, Google Play, and iOS. Click on the link in the description to get your first full month of Magellan TV for free. All the people's names you see on the screen right now, they are people who support us on Patreon. They give us a little money so that we can continue making this show because look, we understand that we are extremely excited about magnetotaxis, but many people aren't, and that's okay. It's a big, diverse world. But with tools like Patreon and great people like these, amazing content about amazing bacteria can still survive on YouTube. So thank you so much to all of them, and if you want to join them, you can go to patreon.com/journeytomicro. If you want to see more from our master of microscopes, James Weiss, you can check out Jam and Germs on Instagram. And if you want to see more from us, there's always a subscribe button somewhere nearby.